Hello, everybody. Kimberly Maska here, your fearless leader here in Spiritual Biz Success. How's everyone doing? I have relocated, for those of you who have been following me for a while. I'm in my new office here. We've moved to Asheville, North Carolina. So this is the new headquarters of Maska Media, which is super exciting. But I want to talk a little bit. I see a lot of the posts in here, and people are really nervous about stepping out as a spiritual leader. And it's a fascinating thing because I get it. I get what it's like to put yourself in a vulnerable position and really step out with your gifts. And a lot of times people, when you have these gifts, right, you've probably had these gifts, hey, Des and Nilo. So when you have these gifts and you're like, it's time to step out. A lot of you, I know, have these gifts. You've got things that you've been hanging on to, these intuitive gifts, these, whether it's psychic or you're a medium or you're a healer, whatever these gifts are that you know you've had them for ages, probably since you were born, or you've had some incredible experience that has happened that has then prompted these gifts to show up, or you usually it's some, you know, the universe knocking us upside the head to show us the gifts that we have so that we really start to step out. But what's interesting is even though you know you have these gifts and you know that you're amazing at them, you get really nervous about stepping out. I see that in here all the time in the post here in Spiritual Biz Success. It's about, you know, I'm afraid to step out. What are people going to say? Is my family going to think I'm crazy? Like, what is going on? And that nervousness keeps you from sharing your gifts with the world. And it's really unfortunate because you were given those gifts for a reason. Source picked you to have those gifts. That's why you have them. And yet, you're being, I'm going to call it selfish, for not stepping out with them. It's like someone gives you a really amazing gift and you're like, it's gorgeous. Could be like, I'm going to use a diamond. I don't know why. If you say you had this beautiful diamond, this rare diamond, and you hide it and no one ever gets to see it, that's really selfish. You ever think about the people that have like these like Renoirs in their house and they're like, why would they hide them? Why would they not share them with the world? Well, you're doing the exact same thing if you are not sharing your gifts. Again, Source picked you to have those gifts for an absolute reason, and you're not stepping out with them. And I know you're not stepping out because you're nervous. You're nervous, you don't have the confidence just yet, and you think about what are people gonna say. Your family probably undermines you a little bit, right? Because you've had these gifts since you were young, and your family just knows those gifts is to be a part of you, and it's just kind of more of a, I don't want to call it dog and pony show, but sometimes it is. They're like, oh, can you do a reading for me? Oh, what do you think of this? They come to you for advice, but they don't really see the true value of what you're doing. And because they do that, we start to question ourselves. We start to doubt the gifts that we have, and you start to doubt that you can serve people. You start to doubt that you can actually make money from that. I mean, I have clients making well into the six figures being spiritual healers. Like, it's so amazing and possible to do, yet all these little doubts creep in and keep us where we are. And the doubts, all they are is our disconnection from Source. If you're doubting anything in your life, it's because you've disconnected from Source. And so take a moment to reconnect, because when you're reconnected with Source, you can see your full potential. And there's no worry, there's no fear. We know that this is what we're supposed to be doing. Why? Because again, Source handpicked you to give you the gifts that you have. That means you're supposed to use them. That means you're supposed to live a life of abundance. That means you're supposed to live the life you were meant to live and live your purpose. And to do that in an amazing way and have a major contribution on this planet so that you're shifting the vibration of the people that need it the most. So if you have these gifts and you're nervous about stepping out, it's time to make a change. This planet needs you. My goodness, just look around at everything that's going on. We need to create this, I don't like to use the word army, this force of people who will come together at a high vibration. You guys may have seen my Facebook posts. I talk about it in here that it's my goal to create 5,000 spiritual entrepreneurs in the next 5 years. And that's because there has to be a shift of consciousness on this planet. So those gifts that you've been given to by Source, you're being incredibly selfish if you aren't stepping out there with them. That's not why you receive them. You didn't receive them to hide them and keep them hidden away from the world and not serving. It's time for you to step out in a massive way. And if you're ready to step out, if you are ready to have the support that you need to be able to step out, reach out. I'll put a little link up here. You can message us, take a look and look at Spiritual Biz Bootcamp. What we do is we shift your vibration around money and we shift your identity so that you can become the spiritual leader that you were meant to be and share those gifts with the world, because that is exactly why those gifts were given to you. So that being said, do not let those doubts and fears keep you from where you want to go. Overcome them. The fear is there to push you over the edge to do something great. If you stand at the edge looking down and being afraid, it'll never happen. You've got to take the leap. You've got to take the leap and know and trust that Source has you through the entire process. So again, if you're ready to do that, if you're ready to take the leap and ready to change your life, go ahead and click the link above, take a look at the training, book a call with my team, and we can help you and see if we are a vibrational match to be able to get you there. So that being said, let me see if there's any comments. So Nilo, your problem is that I get really connected to someone because I know they really need help and healing, but either they're not ready or don't want it or don't pay. I have an offer for free because my soul is deeply wanting to heal and help. So Nilo, what you need to do here, the problem is that you don't know who your ideal client is. So even though, so here's a word we use. We use this all the time. People have to be helpable. We can only help helpable people. This is true. We use this all the time. When we qualify someone to work with me in Spiritual Biz Bootcamp, I have to make sure they're helpable because I can't help someone that's got resistance, and neither can you. And so what's happening is that you're running up against resistance because they're not ready, and now you're wasting your energy on someone and your gifts on someone who isn't ready to receive. So you need to switch that. Instead of like running around trying to do it for free, because sometimes free is too expensive, guys. Free just shows there's no value. And if you don't value what you're doing, Nilo, and you're giving it away for free, and this is true for everyone, because I bet you half the people out there that are watching this don't charge. If you're giving it away for free, that shows you don't value what you're doing. And if you don't value what you're doing, I'm not sure how you expect others to value what you're doing. And if they don't value it, they don't get the results. So you want people to get amazing results, they have to value what you're doing. So stop giving your gift away for free, because it's kind of a waste. It's an unfortunate waste, because the people that you give that gift to really won't make a big change. I've seen it over and over. So Nilo, what you do is you need to find out who your ideal client is. You've got to dive into it. And if you have this amazing gift and you want to connect and you really want to change lives and you really want to have an impact, create a business. That's how you do it. I couldn't create or reach 5,000 spiritual entrepreneurs in 5 years if I didn't have a business, guys. It's a spiritual business, but it is a business. So if you really want to have an impact, that's what you need to be doing. Your business is a vehicle with which to serve and a vehicle with which to get out there at a massive level. Again, there's no way I could even conceive of the idea of helping 5,000 spiritual entrepreneurs if I didn't have a business. Couldn't happen. So if you really feel for people and you really want to help people, stop being selfish with your gift and get it out there. And you get it out there by creating a business. So I hope that kind of helps you, Nilo. I'm reading your comment again to make sure I got it. But you can only help those that are helpable. That's the other piece of that, making sure they're helpable. If they're not helpable, they're not going to listen and they're not going to take the advice and they're going to push you away. And then you have wasted energy. If you find the people that are helpable, then you can totally change their life. They're helpable and they want to be helped. And again, that's why you create the business. The business is how you connect. The business is how you find and refine who your ideal client is. And when you know exactly who your ideal client is, you know that they're helpable, you know that you can help them, then that is when you have a major impact, because you're actually changing someone's life. You're shifting their consciousness. The whole point of what you guys have, these gifts that you have, that we all have, but the whole point of having these gifts is to be able to help shift consciousness on the planet. That's what's going on right now. There's so much happening. That's why we're here. All of the light workers who have awakened are here to shift consciousness. And if you're not doing it, I have to ask you, what in the world are you doing? That's why you were given the gift to be able to do that. So, and how do you do that? You get out there, you create a business. Stop being selfish and hiding your gifts. You create a business, and in that business, you're able to truly serve and really have a major impact. So, Nilo, I hope that answers your question. I'm trying to see if there's anything else. Hello, Lisa. Lisa's just graduating. And Natalie. And then Rachel says, yes, Reiki masters are afraid for charging, right? They're afraid of, well, actually, you're not even talking about being afraid of charging. Reiki master and afraid of practicing healing, feel frozen. Well, that's, again, your disconnect with source. Like, if you have fear and you're afraid to do something, you're just disconnected from source. Because if you were connected with source, source gave you the gift. You gave you the gift to use. So if you're afraid, it's because you're too stuck in the human. You're too stuck in your 3D, and you're afraid of what other people will say, and you're afraid of what's going to happen. So all those fears are just because you're stuck in the 3D. Your human is worried about things. So release the human. Know that source gave you the gifts for a reason. And if you really want to serve, follow source. That's what it's about. Following source. Following source with the gift that you have. And then what do you do with that gift? You want to do it at a massive level? You create the business. That's the answer to the whole thing. But you have to get rid of the fear. You can't be frozen. Source gave you the gift for an absolute reason. So when Lisa says you have to invest in yourself before you can expect others to invest in you, that's absolutely true. I mean, it's law of attraction 101, right, guys? Law of attraction 101. You want someone to invest in you, then be the change you want to see and invest in yourself. That's the only way you can do it. Hey, Victoria, how are you? And then, okay, Neela, who's your answer? Okay, my ideal client is usually ones that have gone through what I have. Yes, that is absolutely true. And then, I get drawn, but then there's resistance again. So yes, if you know your ideal client, see, you're partway there, but now you just got to tighten everything up and actually create the business to make it happen. So Twana, so recall our phone call some time ago. Vetting my level of resistance. My patient has definitely shifted. That's great, Twana. Love to hear it. Life looks different. Excited. I am so happy to hear that you have made some shifts and changes. So that's it, guys. So do not be afraid to step out as a spiritual leader. That's the whole reason why Source gave you the gifts. We are here to shift consciousness. It has to happen. That's why everyone's awakening. And that's why we're seeing all the contrasts around us, is to get us to take action. So we're here to take action, because that is the whole point. And how do you have impact on a massive level? You create a business. And if you're feeling nervous about stepping out with your gifts, you have to reconnect with source. And you have to also not care what other people say, because it has nothing to do with them. And it even doesn't have nothing to do with you. It has to do with the people that you're serving, the fact that you're shifting consciousness. So you have to release all of that, connect with source, know that your greatest way to serve with your gift is to create a business. Your business is the vehicle with which to serve. I could not be out there even saying that I was going to help 5,000 spiritual entrepreneurs create 5,000 businesses if I did not have a business. So that is the answer to it all. So again, guys, I will post a link above if you are ready to make that change and ready to share your gifts with the world as you are meant to do, and you are ready to really step out as that spiritual leader that you are meant to be. I will post the link, watch the training, book a call with my team, and I will see you in Spiritual Biz Bootcamp. Again, I'm Kimberly Maska, your fearless leader here in Spiritual Biz Success, and I'll see you guys in Bootcamp and in the next video. Have an awesome day.